Okay, so good morning everyone and welcome back in today's class. Today we are going to be cover one major topic called the data lookup. Okay, let me open my notepad and tell you. But before I proceed to this data lookup, let me show you in the system. Now, if I open this incident, okay, if I open an incident and go to create new, here how we are using the data lookup. If you see, if I change my impact, let me change impact from 3 to 1. My priority getting changed. See, this is read only, right? I cannot make any changes. If I change my urgency, then again my priority get changed. If I change both, then also my priority get changed. So the point is that from where these changes are coming, it is a script, it is a button, it is a logic, where this has been mentioned, which indicates that if you change the impact or urgency, the priority will be changed. From the interview perspective, if someone asks what do you mean by the data lookup, start with the example that impact urgency changes my priority is the best example of the data lookup. What this means basically that if I make a change in one field on the form level, the other field also get changed. Okay. Today, what we'll do, we will see that if I put the caller something different, then my assignment group should become automatically. Even though this can be done by the assignment tool as well, there's a concept called the assignment tool. But still, as per our understanding, what we'll do, if I change the caller, or let's say if I change the category, my assignment group should be updated. Or if I change my subcategory, my assignment group should be changed. But before that, let's see that how this thing has been configured. Okay. What I will do, I'll click on the go ahead data lookup. It has three things. Chalo yahan se pehle ek baar dekhte hain, fir isko define karenge. In the data lookup, you can see here. Data lookup work on the table level. On a single table, you have multiple data lookups like this one. They have a data lookup on the priority one. The example which we just saw, it is the here. So I am just opening the data lookup definition. We will create one data lookup, don't worry. Let me open this. Okay. Do you remember that we done the transform map? In the transform, what we have, source and destination, right? We done this thing, data mapping we done. What was there? Source and destination. Same thing apply here as well. But here the difference is that source and the matching table. Which field I should pick up from the source table and go to the matching table and give us the result. So what we do here, number one point. Okay. Number one point, we will create our lookup. Lookup means we will create a matcher table specifically. That where it should go and check. It means that if priority is 2 and urgency is 3, then sorry, impact is 2, not urgency. Impact is 2, priority is urgency is 3, then priority become 3. Ye jo cheez hai, ye wala. This is we define in our table. Okay. And to define in table means we have to be create our own table. we have to create our own fields in that particular table. So I will show you that. So if you see, if you go here, this one I'm talking, DL underscore U underscore priority. Let me open it. DL underscore U underscore priority dot li. Let me open this.
Spelling.
Right. Let me copy the table name from here only. This one. So this is the table. In this table, they have only three fields: impact, urgency, and on the basis of that, they are saying the priority. If you click here on the new, let me show you that how the table structure work here. This is select the impact, select the urgency, select the priority. This thing. Once this matcher table is ready, this one, when this matcher table is ready, then what we have to do? We have to create the data lookup definition. Definition, what definition means? It will do source and destination matching, table to table mapping. Source dot field, destination dot field. Remember, in the transform map as well, we have a import set table. We done import set to ServiceNow table, then import set field. You remember that field mapping assist was there. This is the same thing we're doing here. And then finally, okay, so these things are important here. Now what we'll do, we will create our matcher table first of all. Okay, easy to understand the process. Aisa nahi, let's go and go for the table. Okay. Table, as this is a lookup table, so we have to be extend this table. When we create our own table, let me open it here, new. We will give learn. Have a change one. This is my table name. This will come like this. Okay. And let me this one. Matcher table, right? This one we have to be extended. Clear? Because I am utilizing ServiceNow functionality. So I am extending the ServiceNow table only. This one. Matcher field definition. Okay, if you want to see in the other DL table, let me open that table as well. DL underscore U. This one. If I open this, let's see. Extend. Okay, sorry, is that a lookup matcher? Sorry, we are picking up the wrong table. We have to pick up the title. Matcher, lookup matcher table. This one. DL underscore definition. This table we need to be extended. Sorry, guys. Okay, this table we need to be extend. Like this, they extended it. Data lookup matcher rules. Matcher rules. Yeah. Bolo to sab bhul jate hain. This one. Matcher rule. Okay. And save it. Simple. I am not creating any menu for this because I know this menu is not available, is not used by anybody. Okay, so I have this one, data lookup matcher rules. Let me verify data lookup matcher rules. Now what I will do, what is our exercise? Our exercise say that if anyone use the caller name Fred Ludi or Abel Tutor, then the group name should become automatically. Now I have to be store that, right? I have to be create that. So what I will do, I'll create two different fields here. One, I will create to storing the user information. Second, I will create for storing the group information. Type is reference. And let me put ch underscore user underscore. OK. Max length 40. Rest I'm just leaving it as of now because we know that what is the purpose of this. And the reference qualifier we have to be give. I'll say reference from the user table. Sys underscore user. OK. And submit. One field has been created for us. क्लियर हो गई बात यहां तक? एनी डाउट, एनी क्वेश्चन, एनी वन? कौन कौन? ओके, पीपल आर देयर, गुड. क्लियर टिल दिस पॉइंट? व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, लेट मी रिपीट इट अगेन. वी आर लुकिंग फॉर अ न्यू टॉपिक कॉल्ड द डेटा लुकअप. इन दैट डेटा लुकअप द पर्पज इज दैट इफ यू सेलेक्ट वन फील्ड द अनदर फील्ड पॉपुलेटेड ऑटोमेटिकली. लाइक इन अवर इंसिडेंट वी हैव अ impact and urgency. You select impact, you select urgency, the priority value come automatically. We are also doing the same thing, but we are doing it on the change table. If my caller is Fred Ludi, if my caller is Tanvi, if my caller is Harsha, if my caller is Arun, then the group should become like this only. Okay, so those things we have to be defined here. But we have to be define the name very carefully. Now I'll create the second part. We will take only two examples. Again, reference, because from where the group name will come, it will come from the group table. CH. TXT. Let me go and click the reference table is sys underscore user underscore group. This one. Clear? And submit. Clear okay. Let me open this table now. What is the name of our table? U underscore learn underscore change. Okay, these two fields we created. Let me put up the value here. I said if I select the Fred Ludi, okay, the group should become change management. Submit. Let me put one more record here. Able tutor, group should become cab approval. Okay, let me submit this. Now I created the my matcher table, okay, with these two value. If I select the Fred Ludi, it should select the change management. If I select the able tutor, it should select the cab approval. Clear? Now I will create my data lookup definition where I will do the mapping. Actually, new. I want to get the data lookup. This is something newly they introduced in the Rome version. It was earlier as well in the cubic as well, but they enhanced this one, data catalog one. Okay, so it is asking for the name here. I say CSG underscore look underscore learn. It says what is the source table you have, on which table you want to implement this data lookup. I said I want to put on the change table. Okay, let me open. Let's go request. It will come. I will type. It will come up. Okay. This is the source table where you want to match it. I said I want to match it to the my table. This one. Right. This is the table we created just now. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now I click this. So what I'm doing? I'm doing table to table mapping. I did not reach to the field level till now. I'm just doing the table to table mapping. Now I click on the save here. Now what I will do? I will do the matching. What matching I will do? I will say caller of this should match to the user of this. If it match, what you want to do? So here I will do the matcher and setter. Matcher means match the value. Setter means set the value. So I'll do here, click on the new. Now source table, source means chain table. Go here and search for the caller. There is no caller. Let me open the chain table in the parallel. Let's see what name we have in the अरे क्या हो गया चेंज डिस्कोर Let open any changes to see that what is the name of the field here. It is called the requested by. Okay, go here. What I'm doing? Match the requested by. Isko kisse match karna hai? In the matcher table, match to the this one. See this one, right? Yes or no? Match the requested by to the user field which I created in my table. Submit. Next thing we will do. Wait. Any doubt? Anything till this point? Anyone? Arun, Harsha, Tanvi, Dhanashi, Prashant, Vishwajit. Anyone, any doubt, any question till this point?
No, sir, we can match field manually one by one.
To match the fields manually one by one. It is not a transform map where you will get assist. No, you have to match the field one by one only.
Okay.
Okay, now matching has been done. What I want? I want the setting should be done here. Go here, click new. I said when the requested by match with the my lookup table user, what it should do? It should done the mapping as well. Setting as well, assignment group. Kahan ka assignment group pick up karke leke hai? Yahan ka. And submit. Okay, one matching, one setting. You have multiple matchings and one setting as well. Okay, now my lookup definition has been ready. Let me reload my page. Okay, now we will do the practical part. What we said that requested by should be Fred Ludi, right? Yes or no? If requested by his friend Ludi, the assignment group should come automatically. Not coming. Okay, no problem. Let me change. If requested by his able tutor, then I tab out. It is not coming. Correct, it is not coming. That I agree, it is not coming. But let me try to save this form. Okay, just save this form and let's see then any changes happen or not. See, now it is coming. Right, this is what we done, right? Yes or no?
Right.
But the question is that, Atul, why it was not working earlier? Right. Now, let me go here and see this. What it's saying? Run on form change, run on insert. I said run on insert. Remove this. Save this. Okay. Now I go here and let's see what happened, because now logic has been over. Only few things pending which need to be do little R&D part. Fred Ludi still not coming. Let's see. I try to save it. No, it is not coming. It means something goes wrong here in our this part. Okay. What went wrong here? Let me do something like this. I'll put insert. I'll put update as well. Okay. Now I try to save this. And go here. This is one of the toughest topics I always hate. Generally, I fail once or twice in this topic. Okay, let's go here. It is the right Fred Ludi we put it or not? Let's put able tutor. To save this. For able to do it's working. For this, it is not working. Let's see the profile of Fred Ludi first. Guys, give me 1 minute. Okay, the reason can be, let see the Fred Ludi account. Maybe Fred Ludi is a end user and that is the reason it is not able to do that particular changes. Okay, let go here and what is the table name? u_learn_change.list. Let me open the Fred Ludi account. Let's see what type of role he has. Fred Ludi and all the things are here. Oh, he has ITL role, that's fine. But why it's not working? Let me change the group for him. Maybe he's a part of this. इंच के अलावा कोई ग्रुप नहीं है क्या? Let me try major incident. question. What I can say. Okay, let's put database team. Let's try to put. Okay. No other change is required. Let's go here and try to reload this page. No working. Let me save and then see if any changes are coming or not. Yes, now the changes are coming. Now if this thing is working fine, let me go to my lookup definition here, because few things required here to understand. Number one point. So on the top, it says that when you want to run your particular lookup on the form change, on insert or update, these things also depend on the these things. What it say? It says that requested by this exit lookup match means, suppose in the Excel sheet when you search, it says, do you want to do the exact matching or what you want? You said, yes, I want the exact matching. So put it as a true here. Now let's try it again. Maybe it's giving a problem there only because it's not, it's getting multiple Fred Ludi name. And let's try this. Generally, we create one or two only. See, it's showing two Fred. And let me try to add it here. No, it's not working. Still not working. I just have one point, guys, here. Okay. The reason is that it is not working. The what I can be thinking here, because in the Roam release, ServiceNow introduced a new concept called the auto assignment. Okay. What this is that if you select any configuration item, and that configuration item has a support group name, then that group will be override the assignment group. And maybe that is the reason it is being conflicting, and when I click on the save, then my data lookup definition work actually. Otherwise, if you see here, if I go here and put the able tutor, and click on the save here, see, it did not replace it. Why? If you go here in the setter, we make it false as a replace. Let me make it true as a replace. So in this case, if you make a change, now if I save this for a minute, and now I change it. Let me save, and now I'll change it to the able tutor. Why? Because we mentioned that replace always is true, right? And save. Now it has been change here. So this is the way that what I can say, my data lookup definition work in the service now. Anyone has any doubt, any question on this part? Simple fundamental, we had to create our own data lookup table first. We have to put the values for the matching and the setting. Then we have to go and create the data lookup definition where we will do the source and destination matching. Once that has been done, then we will do the field level matching and finally we execute it. Clear ho gaya yahan tak? Koi doubt kisi ko? Koi question kisi ko? Let me come here. Yes, Arun.
No question, Atul. I mean, so this will take some time, data lookup part. So,
yes. So what I can suggest you here that try to read these out of the box. Try to read those definition first. This one, like assignment lookup. Right. Let's see. Let me show you that assignment lookup is DL underscore U underscore assignment. Open this table. Let see what it's saying. That match the four field. Match subcategory, match CMDB, match location, match category. If all these are matches, then set the assignment group and assign to. Let open this. DL underscore U underscore. This one. Let's see the values, what they put it here. See, so for the example, they just put one value here. Category this, subcategory this. CI is nothing, assigned to Fred Ludi. And assignment group is empty. Okay, so generally we create, and that is not a customization, this is a configuration only. But yes, when we create a table, that is a customization. You have to create a matching table, that is a customization for you.
Yeah, right.
Okay. Yes, Ashwarya.
Sorry, just got confused with the business rule and data lookup.
Okay. Business rule means we are coming on maybe not today, but tomorrow, day after tomorrow, we'll discuss on that particular part. Business rule basically which take your value and save into the database. Data lookup basically which changes the value of your field on the selection of something else. If my cousin came, then I will go to the mall. This is the data lookup. He came or not came, I still go to the mall. I can say this is the business rule for me. Clear? So yeah. this is the difference between the data lookup and the business rule.
Okay.
Clear. Now one more point, which means not point, I can say. One more thing which want to be discussed here is that the UI action. Okay. What is the UI action? Let me open the change form. The buttons you are able to see here, all these, this one. If you right click on this, this is called the context menu. These things, this all option. If you click here, these are, let me scroll down. These are. Then if I go to this thing, this one, this, these all. These all are called the UI action. Called the UI action. And to build any UI action, you have to be write the script in the background. Okay. Once we done our scripting part now, maybe after in 2 or 3 days, then I'll show you one example. As per my best knowledge, I'll try to show you one example that how these UI action actually work in the practical part. But today we will see that how I can create my own UI action. Let me go here and search for the UI action. Under system definition, we have the UI action. on the change form, we guys see the save, right? If I filter out by this word save here, see 101 definition of the save here. Let me see on the change table. What is, maybe it is a global one, right? This one you can see. These are the global one which can be utilized everywhere at any point of time. Let me see the new here. And search for the incident table. See. Incident table, new, 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 and new. One new is normal list view on this part. Here you will get a new button, right? On the list view, that is the one new button option here. One new is related list. Here you go. When you, let me see the change one. Like here you want to add a new. This one, yeah. This is new. Okay. So the thing is that ServiceNow say you need to be create only once, but you can utilize this UI action at number of places. And now we will create our UI action. Okay, let me create a new UI action here. What is the name of the UI action? I want to go for the LNG. Okay, and UI action is also a customization because you have to be write the code in the background. On which table you want to display? I want to display on the change table. This one. Okay. Action name, that what need to display on the change form. I said display as a learn group. Okay. And let me save this. Nothing else I am doing it here, nothing else. Let me go and reload my change form. Okay. My button is not appearing here. Correct? It is not appearing?
Yes, not appearing.
It means we did not do the correct setting here. Just 1 minute, guys. Sorry, yeah. Okay. So why it is not appearing? Because we did not make a settings that it should appear or not. See, this is the place where you can play. Form button. On the form button, yes. On the context menu, yes. On the form link, yes. I tick three boxes. Let me show you here now. Okay. Go here and reload. See, this button is appearing on the form. Yes, what we did on the context. It is appearing as a form link. Appearing. Clear till this point? Means only you need to be write the code only once, but you will get a benefit at the number of places. That is the beauty of service now. Clear? Any doubt, any question till this point? Now, if I want to make a change in the format of the color, this button, sorry. You have this one. Okay. List banner button. Okay. List bottom button. Okay. List contents menu. Okay. List choice. Okay. List link. Okay. I'm just ticking all the save. Go here. Save. Go here. And reload my page. See, number one, it becomes the red color. Destructive style we have picked up it. Okay. Then context menu is appearing. Yes, we saw here. Yes, we verified. Let me scroll down here. Yes, here. Yes. Now, what I will do, I'll open the change list view as well. All just to show you, because that is be working on the list view only. See, it is appearing here as well now. Is it appearing here somewhere? No, it is not appearing here. That's fine. Now, what we say in the list, scroll down. Number one, appearing here, appearing here, appearing here. Now, any doubt, any question before I speak further? Harsha, Tanvi, Arun, Dhanashi, Ashwini, Aishwarya, Vishwajit, Prashant. Tell me, guys.
No, clear, sir.
No.
Now the thing is that if this is be fine, Atul, when I click on this, see. If I click on this, something should be happen. Like if I click on the new form open. Why? Because there is some code has been mentioned in the new button. If I click on this LNG here, it is not doing anything, right? Why?
Yes, sir, because
we did not do any coding in the button level. Okay. Now, before that, let me do this thing as well here. This thing has been clear. Now I come to this part. Show insert, show update. When you want to make this form, this button visible, when I'm inserting the record and when I'm updating the record, let me say, remove this and say, let me show you. I go here. Reload my page. See, this button is not there. Why? Because I say don't show on the insert. If I submit this change, now I click on the save. Now that button will be appear. See why? Because I mentioned show on the update. That is a thing. Okay. Client basically, if you want to, I'll not say that how it can be work, but basically it should be work with the client scripting part as well. Compatibility part you have to say. See, I never use this, that what is the exact purpose of this? You can try and you can check at your end. Now the override means, suppose I have button here called the update. I have button called the LNG. I want to override update button. This should not be visible, or this should not be work properly. Only this button should work properly. Then we can override as well. It's a override, which button you want to override? I want to override update. Now I have 100 of updates, so I am confused that which update I am talking here. So what it will do? It will hide this button via this button. That is the purpose of the override here. Let me try. Delete. See, a lot of deletes are there. So we cannot be do anything like this. But you can try it. Okay. Create two buttons, two custom buttons, and try to override by one. Okay. That is saying you can do it here. Any message you want to display. Basically on the client scripting part, get a message. We will see when we do the scripting part, then I'll show that how you can write this part specifically. Any hint you want to put on click, you want to call any function on, sorry. You want to call any function on the click of this, some calculation, a lot of things are there. So you can call that. This is one of the topic which is pure on the technical part. And your friend Atul Grover don't know that part. Okay, but I can tell you, when you learn the scripting, you can do these things very easily. And to understand these points, go to the out of the box UI action. And this is the place where you write your code. If you want to display any message, you can write the code here. That I will try to give you in next 2 or 3 days. Okay. But this is the way that my, what I can say, UI action work. UI action visibility. Who can see this UI action if I click here? And I can edit it. A user who has an IT role can see this. A user who has an admin role can see this. So you can define this part. Remember, the concept of the catalog, available or not available for, the same fundamental work here as well. For whom you want to show this button? For whom you want to do? For whom do you don't want to show the button? Clear ho gaya yahan tak point? Kisi ko doubt? Any clarification? Anyone? Let me come here. Yes, guys, anyone, any doubt, any question? Are yes, Nehrut, bolo. Okay, I assume no doubt, no question, no clarification required. Good. Now I will start a new topic. And that is called the scripting. Let me try to open my khajana here. Today we will go for the introduction part, and tomorrow we will go for some practical part of the scripting. Okay. Again, the details which I know, I will share. Which I don't know, I will not share. Okay. Before that, let me have a quick point here. Tanvi Harsha Dhanashi. विश्वजीत, प्रशांत, निखिल बंसल आज भी नहीं है, हर्ष, अरुण, ऐश्वर्या, any doubt till this point? Anyone has any doubt till this point? Yes or no, both are option open for you. Yes, Tanvi, yes or no?
No sir, no.
All clear? Any doubt?
No doubt till
now. Okay, good. But we will not take much time for today because I know already two topics are covered and it's little heavy. Now, yes, Arun, you have question.
No question actually. So with this, that's how the, I mean to say, the end user, they are able to see those options, right? So these things
work out for the not end user, your fulfillers, not end user. End user can see only the, what I can say, mainly the portal part.
Okay. No, I'm saying about the in the production side. I'm saying it. Mm-hmm. Let's say when our requirement is fulfilled, right, then when we're matching our LNG part, these part, right, the buttons when we click it. So like in the normal Excel, when we hover a mouse, right, it shows up, right. This is meaning of this, like file view.
Right.
Like,
close, yes, right. Yes.
So I'm just because they have to give the little hint for the user, right?
Before
clicking, please have the small, you know, information like what this will do. Then accordingly you take the action that way.
Correct. Okay, now I'm coming to the new topic. It's called the scripting part. But before I go for the scripting, I have few things to be discussed on the terms part. Okay. Mainly we are going to be discuss two things, client script and the business rule. There's a 10, 15, 20 topics are there which people cover in different trainings of the scripting part, but I have no idea. This thing I captured from a book called the Master in Scripting ServiceNow by the Packet, P-A-C-K-T, Packet Publication. It is a very good book. You will be easily find out that book on the internet and download it. If did not find, let me know, I'll share the book with you. Okay, it says basically three concepts: customization, configuration, and custom development. Till now we see customization means anything which is not available in my tool, or I want to change the behavior of my tool so that it can give me the best possible solution is called the customization. Okay. Second part says the configuration. Tool is working, a tool has been defined as expected. I am just putting my data in that and making some plus or minus changes, like changing the UI policy, changing the SLA, changing the notification. These are the configuration, not the customization. Okay. If this is the thing, then what do you mean by the custom development? Custom development says basically when you are changing this one, this includes the custom development on both ServiceNow application the nuksan of the copy pasting. Okay, this includes the custom development on the both sides, ServiceNow application and the new application you develop by changing the baseline. It means what is the custom development specifically is that when you use ServiceNow as the tool and on the top of that you start working something new application is called the custom development. Remember the custom scoping, custom application we see. That is the custom development. So customization, creation of new field, new table is customization. Configuration, just to put the data in ServiceNow, which we already have built up, the tables already built up, we just put the data. Custom development, when you create your new application on the baseline of the ServiceNow, that is called the custom development for a user. And to do the custom development, ServiceNow not much recommended. But still we are doing because our client has a requirement. Our customer has a requirement, so we have a that thing on the place. So we do the custom development. These three terms are totally different with each other. According to customization, if you writing the script as well, it is a customization. The in the UI action, if you write any script, it is a customization. In the UI policy, if you're writing a script, it is a customization for them because you are changing the behavior of a tool now. Okay, but it depends. It depends from the company to company. Like in my project, customization means that when you create a new field, is a customization. When you create a new table, is a customization. But in my previous project, even if you write a one line of the code, it is a customization. Okay, so it depends from customer to customer, company to company, who is implementing, who is working, and who is doing this particular part for the consumer or the client. Then the question comes, there are five type of customization. Okay. Please mention these things in your CV that you know the basics of customization and the configuration. Because this has been very good impact. We have the five level of customization. Okay, number five, what it says, mandatory customization required for the regulatory and the compliance. Like I purchase a house from the builder or a flat from the builder. Builder did not put the main gate, the safety door, which we call as. Okay. I said I want it by now. He said, sorry, you cannot do it now. Let me get the completion certificate, then you can do anything. I said I will not take the possession until unless you will do this thing. That is called the number five level customization, which is required for the compliance. My parents will not happy because they will say, hey, your house is not safe. That is the purpose of this particular this thing. You cannot, you have to do this kind of customization because that is required the compliance and the regulatory part. Number four level, value four, critical customization is must realize the business value. Means this is, you can still avoid, but this is important from the business perspective. I want that every customer who log into my system should get a pop-up message. Thank you so much, Mr. XYZ. Uska pura naam, his complete name, address, his account balance should become on the top when he log in. That is the critical customization, which is driving a business value here. Okay. Number three, medium level. This says that you can go for the customization, but see if any workaround available or not for this. I go to some hotel and I am hobby to make a black tea or the white tea, or I can say the black coffee or something like different. That material is not available in that room. Do I have any workaround? Oh, I have some tulsi leaves with me. Let me use that only. That is the workaround. Instead of asking to the hotel person, I have the workaround available with me and I can use that part. That is the number three level of customization. Number two level, which help to the consumer specifically. Low customization supports service experience, mainly to build something good to have to that part. If suppose I did not show you the service now, in the last 33 days, it is tough for you guys to be understand. To enhance that experience, I doing this customization in front of you. Okay, it is not required that it give any business value or not. It is good to have. See, the concept used in the IT, good to have, must to have, or what I can say, good, must. Mainly these two terms we use. Good to have means if you put, I will be happy. Must to have means no, you have to put it this. Otherwise, my customer will not happy. And finally, number one, no value customization does not support improved service experience. Just only for the sake of, okay, you want, I can do it. It's a little customization, I can do it for you. Not a bigger customization. Okay, so remember this five value score of the customization. Okay, so these are the important points which I want to tell you. You can see here, what is the customization, what is the configuration here. Okay, you can read these documents. These documents you can get it in the ServiceNow site very easily. Search for the customization and the configuration best practice of ServiceNow. It is a PDF file where I cut it out these things. It says that what type of requirement you have and what type of customization it will be. It is a complex, medium, high, very complex, what type of customization it will go. Like build a new global application. I know it is a critical one. Change baseline business rule. It is a critical but mandatory one because it's a business need. Build complex custom integration. It is a critical one and mandatory as well. Being a consultant, it is important for you to understand in which category your customization is falling. Number 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And what is the priority of that business need? Critical, medium, high, low, mandatory, non-mandatory, good to have, must to have. These things you have to be identified. And believe me, these things not come on the day one. These things come only from the experience. Very truly on that part. Maybe today it is very heavy for you to understand these concepts. But down the line, 6 months, 1 year, you will be able to understand this. Okay, any doubt, any question?
No, sir.
Okay, so I'll not continue now. Let we close the call here only because I want to be spend the complete 1 hour on the scripting part, which we discuss from tomorrow. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now what you have to be do, let me find out that book for you guys. Wait, let me send it to you. I know nobody will put efforts to find out that book. Why I'm not getting option for the sending anything? Okay, add files. Because I downloaded this book when we kick off this session or kick off this our batch 4. Customization, this one, mastering. If you want to read about the service now, you can follow this book. If you want to read about the scripting part, you can follow this book. Both are same or different? Sorry, this one. ServiceNow scripting, awesome book, very fine English, very beautiful English that has been defined here. Okay, and I'm follow this book only. We'll just follow 40-30 pages on this book. Yesterday we will, tomorrow we will go for the same thing only. Okay, download this book. It is good for you to be read, specifically the people or the person who want to build their career as a ServiceNow developer. Read this book, 200-300 pages book is this. Read this book, you will get a lot of new things, lot of new things. Okay. Any other doubt, question, clarification?
Atul, was the link of BA book correct?
BA book, basically you can search for the BA book 1.6. You will find out that. I need to be find out in my let me see if I have something for the BA box as well. okay, I got it. This BA box, this one, V3 version. Okay. Read this book as well. Sorry. Okay. Good.
No, sorry. No, I sent a link the other day, I think.
Okay. You sent. Yes.
I just want to confirm if it is the same. Okay, fine. Thanks.
Yes, that is the same. BA box, V3 member. Okay.
Okay
guys, so let's take a break for today here only. Let me stop the recording.